Welcome to the City of Yuma Parks and Rec afternoon craft class. Today's class is called A is for Author, B is for Book. Today we are going to be learning the difference between fiction and nonfiction books, and we're also going to be creating our own little mini book using index cards, rubber bands, paper clips, and a hole punch. Let's get started. In today's class of A is for Author, B is for Books, we are going to be learning the difference between fiction and nonfiction books. Here's one trick that I use to remember the difference. Fiction starts with an F, so I remember fiction, fake. It doesn't mean that it's a fake story, but it just reminds me that it's a made-up story and the characters are not necessarily real. Nonfiction is a real story. Think of like science books, history books. Those type of books are nonfiction or not fake. All right, so let's look at the comparison. Fiction books, some things that we can look for are that they are not real. The characters in them are not real. Someone made them up. For example, Cat in the Hat is a fiction story, because Cat in the Hat is not a real cat, it's a made-up cat, made up by the author Dr. Seuss. Fiction books tell a story. So if you have an imagination and you're coming up with a story in your mind, then that story is a fiction story. Fiction stories are made for fun. The authors want to entertain us. They want to tell us a story for fun. They often use illustrations. So in my stickers here, I added some examples. Cinderella is an illustration. It's a drawing. This dragon is an illustration. It's a drawing. So when we're looking at books, if they have illustrations, that might be a clue that it might be a fiction story. Also, fiction stories have characters and a setting. That's another clue that it is a fiction story. Nonfiction stories are a little different. Nonfiction stories tell us about something real. So maybe you want to teach us about sharks, or about insects, or about frogs. If you're using the book to teach us something about something real in our world, then most likely it's a nonfiction book. Nonfiction books give us facts. They tell us how much an animal weighs. They tell us the date when something happened in history. They give us facts. They are used for learning or giving us information. They usually include real photos. So in my stickers here, I've added real photos of a real shark or a real dog. If we see real photos, that's usually a clue that the book is nonfiction. And nonfiction books tell us about true places and true things versus characters and settings. Now that we understand the difference between fiction and nonfiction, let's go write our own story. You need to decide for today's story, are you going to make up a fiction story, something that's fake and you make up yourself? Or are you going to write a nonfiction story, teaching us about something in our world? All right, today we are going to be making a mini book that we can use to write our story in. You could write a nonfiction story in here or a fiction story in here. And you'll have lots of pages for writing and even a cover for your title. Let's get started. For this craft, you're going to need some index cards. Index cards can be found at an office supply store, Walmart, or even at the dollar store. I'm gonna use a colored piece for my cover and the white pieces for my pages on the inside, but that's not necessary. You could use just white if you wanted to. So I'm going to get my green card to be my cover, and then I'm gonna put maybe two pages in there, because remember, as we fold these, it's actually gonna create more than two pages to our book. I don't want it super thick because then it's going to be hard for me to use my hole punch. Let's get started by putting the colored paper on top of my two white index cards. Make sure they're all lined up nice and neat, and then fold them in half like a birthday card. When you're folding them, make sure all the corners are lined up. Make those corners kiss. Then make a nice crease going down the spine of the book. Now, the spine always goes on the left side and the pages open up on the right side. So make sure your spine is on the left. Now, I'm going to go in with my hole punch. You might need a grown-up to help you with this because there's quite a few layers in there now and it's kind of hard to punch through. You're going to punch a hole towards the top near the spine. And then another one on the spine near the bottom. Now I've got my two holes punched. I'm going to use a paper clip and a rubber band to bind this together. So I'm going to get started by looping my rubber band onto my paper clip. I'm going to bring it down to the bottom side here. And then I'm going to fish it through the first hole in my book binding. Get through there, little guy. There we go. Now I'm going to bring the rubber band down to the next hole, and it's nice that it stretches. And I'm going to fish it through that hole and connect it using that paper clip. Now make sure your paper clip is folded so it'll stay closed, and you've got the perfect little book. You can add your title here, you could add illustrations and stickers, and then you've got plenty of pages to write your fiction or non-fiction story. Have fun creating your book today!